Okay, people, some safe driving in the snow tips. As you can see, it's getting dusk now. It's 4:21 in the afternoon and visibility is quite good, although everybody should be having the headlights on by now. Driving along, as you can see, the roads haven't been gritted and there's a nice layer of slushy snow on top. Keeping your vehicle at a nice steady pace is the key at all times. When other vehicles are approaching, kind of keep over to the left a little bit just to make sure if they make a mistake, they're not going to plow too hard into you. Plan ahead, look at the road ahead. I know it sounds simple, but look at the road ahead. See what's coming up. If you've got a junction coming up, is a possibility somebody could come sliding out that junction into you. Slowing down in this weather, okay, use your gears, okay? Drop your gears down. I'm currently in fourth gear doing about 26 miles an hour. So what I'm gonna do now, there's a mini roundabout approaching. See vehicles there, so I'm now into third gear, slowing down. What I'm going to do is I'm going to show you a stop, okay? Dropping down into second gear, okay? Slightly putting on the brake, tapping the brake. There we go, into first gear, nice and clear, nice and gently moving off, not like normal. A little less acceleration, a little less clutch coming out, nice and easy. Keep your steering wheel as straight as you can, try not to wobble it left to right, because that's when you start to get your aquaplaning but on the snow front, okay? Vehicle here coming along, not cleaned his headlights, as you can see, doesn't help. If you stick with the highway code, you must clear your headlights and everything, they are visible. So that's basically nice and neat. I know it sounds common, but there are so many people that sort of don't take these things into consideration. That snow is dangerous, it's icy, it's wet, your tyres don't grip, you will slide. You might think, okay, I'm going forward, that's fine, turning slightly, you can cause the weight of your vehicle, 1-2 tons of vehicle, suddenly hitting a nice little patch and you're going sideways. Don't matter how much you brake, you're not going to stop. If you do get into a skid or a slide, okay, don't whack on the brakes. Tap your brakes, so pump them on, off, on, off, on, off. Tapping the brakes will give you a better control. Also, make sure you turn into the slide, okay? So, I'm just going to give it a bit of... No. We can't slide, we're in four-wheel drive, it's a bit difficult for us. When you slide, whichever direction you suddenly slide, so if we were turning right and the back end starts to swing out to the left, okay, turn your steering wheel to the left, turn into the slide. It gives your vehicle that more grip on the road, makes you catch it better. You have to excuse the talking because obviously we're driving at the same time here. That's it, keeping everything nice and clear for you. And that's it really, driving in the snow is not as bad as people think. Just give yourself that extra braking distance, okay? Take your time, use your headlights, give that extra little thing, don't take any chances, okay? Use your gears, do not slam on your brakes. The minute you slam on your brakes, you'll suddenly skid, okay? And once you start skidding, there's not a lot you can do, you're just gonna keep going with the momentum. Okay, if you take your foot off the brake, that's fine, you're gonna release your wheels up, so you're not gonna skid as much, you might get a little bit more traction. Tap the brakes, drop down gears, turn to a different direction, okay? If you come into a major skid where you think you're going to have a head on, turn your steering wheel to the side and let your vehicle go sideways into whatever you're getting at, because again, using your vehicle to slow you down sideways, and if you smack into anything, a lamppost, a tree or whatever, hopefully if you hit it side on, you'll be able to continue your journey and you're not going to be stuck out in the freezing cold. If you hit your radiator and you bust it, or your front suspension or anything like that to do with steering, you're gonna be quite stuck. You're gonna have to wait for recovery, and that in this weather, even they're gonna struggle at some point. Obviously, if you're aiming for a person, God forbid, you know, do whatever you can, okay? Try not to panic, as easy as, you know, it's easier said than done. Tap your brakes, pump them, drop gear, try and move out of the way, turn into the skid, and try and accelerate off very gently, tapping, tapping, tapping. It's far easier for me to say and do because we've had the advanced driver training, we've done all of this, but seriously, just take your time everyone, and hopefully it'll be nice and easy. Coming into little gaps like this, your vehicle will slide. If you went through too fast, just stick it nice and slow. And that basically, hopefully should help you a bit. If you do get stuck in snow, or you hit a patch, don't accelerate rapidly on a standstill, because once you've stopped, that's it, okay? Don't grind away at the thing, you'll just make ice underneath you. Put it into reverse, see if you can reverse off of the patch. Again, nice and slow. Wiggle your steering wheel left to right, left to right, left to right. hopefully should get you backwards a little bit. If that doesn't work, okay, try going forward again. Try use a rocking motion on your car, but watch your clutch. All right, don't burn your clutch out, because then you'll be in serious trouble. Okay, at all times, try and keep momentum going. If it's on a slippy patch, try not to stop. If you can avoid stopping, try so. Just go down to a nice, slow pace. That's it. Nice, slow pace, and you should hopefully continue your journey. There you go, we're slipping now. Okay, cool, that's good. Okay, I can feel my wheels now skidding underneath. We're in 20 miles an hour in second gear, moving into third. We're still in four-wheel drive, so we've got that little bit of extra traction. Coming up to the bends. Taking a bend like this, 30, 35 miles an hour, is going to make you spin off. Do break down somewhere or anything like that, wrap up, okay, keep your feet and your hands as warm as you can, keep your sense of your body. The reason why you can't keep your heating fans, because you don't want to be sort of walking around and having difficulties. In this day and age, you shouldn't be out anywhere too remote that you're going to be out there for hours, okay. Carrying a foil blanket or a flask of hot water in these conditions in your car is always a good idea. Extra blankets, things like that. All depend on where you live and where you are, you know, there should be somebody around. Here, where we're about to go now, as you can see, we're about to hit a country road. So if we were to get stuck out here a little bit, it's going to be a little bit more time consuming for someone to get out to us. In the back of this vehicle, we carry a snow shovel, a couple of snow shovels, foldable, collapsible. We carry some extra tracks. We've got some snow socks. They're quite good, actually. Asda have been selling them for £35. They're a material sock that you can put on, especially on this kind of weather, and it will give you the extra grip. All different sizes, brilliant bit of kit. Bag of salt in the back of your car. Okay, if you do get stuck, put a bit of salt in your front of your wheels, wait for a few minutes, off you go again. Okay, keep the momentum going, keep your seatbelts on at all times. I've seen people take seatbelts off because they're trying to lean forward and look what they're doing. No. Okay, keep them on at all times. As you can see, there's another Land Rover in front of us, or A4x4 of some description, and he's going pretty fast. Some people in 4x4s do like to give it a bit of welly to show off, but don't we all have a little bit of play every now and again? Hopefully this ain't too boring for you. But yeah, so what we'll do is we'll let you watch a little bit of the journey now. Probably put a bit of music on for you. See if you can enjoy it. Snow driving in the UK. Okay, don't know what this guy stopped for in the road here with his hazards on. What a place to stop. You know, he's now going to cause an obstruction to everybody else. He obviously doesn't think or care. Yeah, what can I say? Some people. Okay, we've now hit some snow traction here. Uphill. Just going to cover you off a second, just because of where we're getting into the village. You can have a look in a second. As soon as we get past the marker post, that's it. Got to keep everybody's privacy, you know, the main concern in this thing. Okay, we are slipping quite nicely. You can feel it under the foot. Taking time. Thank you.
show you a few things. Show you a few things.
That will conclude our little snow track for you today. Hopefully we'll come back with some more videos for you very shortly. Take care and keep watching. This production was brought to you by Stormforce Security, where your security is our priority.